ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम 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 ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय The liberating power of Bhagavad Gita in daily life. However, I will share some of my thoughts on Bhagavad Gita and liberation as it is mentioned in the Shastra. Bhagavan Shankaracharya, in his commentary on Bhagavad Gita, in his introduction, he says, what the Gita contains. What is dealt with in Bhagavad Gita?
When he says, Tadidam Gita Shastram Samastha Vedartha Sara Sangraha Bhutam. Shankaracharya says that this Gita contains the essence of the teachings of the Vedas. What is told in the Vedas, that he has condensed, Bhagavan Sri Krishna has condensed in 700 slokas, which have been written later by Bhagavan Vyasa in his Mahabharata. So, he says, Tadidam Gita Shastram Samastha Vedartha Sara Sangraha Bhutam. So, it is the Sara, it is the essence of the Vedic teachings. Gita contains that. So Veda has been condensed, like a capsule it has been brought in Gita. And what Veda says, what is the content of the Veda, what are the essential teachings in the Veda. So that also Shankaracharya in his introduction says, Dividohi Vedokto Dharmaha Pravritti Lakshanascha Pravritti Lakshano Nivritti Lakshanascha. So Veda speaks about two dharmas. Vividohi Vedokto Dharmaha. Two types of dharma. One is Pravritti Lakshanaha. The other is Nivritti Lakshanaha. I think those who are here, they all understand what is Pravritti. Pravritti means action. And Nivritti means absence of action. No action. Renunciation. So the Veda speaks about two types of dharmas, pravritti lakshano, nivritti lakshana. So it speaks about pravritti and it speaks about nivritti. Then why should it speak about that? Then he says, jagataha sthiti karanam praninam sakshat apyudaya nishraya hetuhu. So this pravritti lakshana and nivritti lakshana is told essentially to keep this activity, the world going actually. Bhagavan has created this. He has made a srishti. That srishti should go on. Suppose if you plant a, you put a seed and some plan comes, then we want to see that it exists. It bears fruit. It bears flowers. So, in order to maintain this universe, what he has created, Jagataha Sthiti Karanam, what has been created in order to sustain that, maintain that, these two dharmas are told. Pravritti Lakshanaha and Nimurti Lakshanaha. These two dharmas are told for that purpose. And also he says, Praninam Sakshat Apnudaya Nishrayasa. Nishraya Heduhu. And these two dharmas are for Abhyudaya and Nishraya. Abhyudaya, many of you may be knowing Abhyudaya. Abhyudaya means prosperity, plenty, richness. Abhyudaya Heduhu, Nishraya Heduhu. Nishrayas, Abhyudaya and Nishrayas means highest good. Abhyudaya means good, plenty. Everything should be plenty here. You want everything plenty here. You want plenty of food. You want everything plenty here. Ashram should go well. We need comforts. So it's a common desire. You want some good food to eat, and then good bed to sleep, and a good place to walk around. So there's a natural desire, not only in us, even in the plants, they want to have good light and good food from the soil. If the soil is not yielding, giving good food, the plant will die. So it will try to put the roots where water is there, where it can get food. So that's why he has used the word praninam. It does not mean human beings, even the animals. The animals will walk miles. If summer season comes, if there is no water here, the animals know where the water is. They will go. They will migrate. The trees will go like this, the coconut trees. For the sake of light, it goes like this. And they want plenty of light. If there is some problem here, it will go this way. So there is a natural tendency in everyone here. In all things here, all living beings, they want to be happy here. In order to be happy, they need certain essential things. They want food, they want shelter, they want some creature comforts. So all these things put together is up to there. So Veda speaks about up to there, dharma. What dharma you should follow, so that everything will be plenty here. You will be able to enjoy that. You will be happy here. And then it says, it also speaks about the highest good. Renunciation means, it's not that throwing away everything. Renunciation means everything is fine. Above that, transcending these things, there is a much higher ananda. If up to the plenty, if richness, if everything is plenty, if there is prosperity, if you are happy, is there anything higher than this? A better happiness is there. Is there is more happiness possible? Then they say, yes, prosperity is needed to be happy. Everything should be plenty. But beyond this, there is something which will make you more happy. So that is word Nishraya. And all these things cannot be translated into English or any other language. So these words have been used by the rishis with a lot of import of meaning. And by constant use of that, you get to know what does it mean actually. So the Veda speaks about the two dharmas, Pravritti Lakshana Dharma, the activities, action, so that you earn everything, you become rich. Rich not only in money, rich in flora, rich in fauna, everything rich here. Water should be rich, the air should be good, our fire should be good. The cow should yield well. The tiger should look very beautiful. Tiger looks beautiful. So if a small baby goes and show you the, you take him to a zoo, looks at the tiger and smile, enjoy it actually. I want to touch it. So everything is beautiful here. So everything we want to have richness in everything. Don't think sannyasi is actually throwing away everything. That's the wrong concept actually. It is something higher than that. So the richness is that plenty, prosperity and plenty. Let everything be plenty here. Everything be prosperous. So this is a famous mantra. Urdhvam jigadu bheshajam samno astrujyupate sam chatushpate. The other day I quoted. Let all the trees grow well. Let there be rich flora. Let everything be green here. God's own country, they call it Kerala. So everything is green, so beautiful. And all good flowers. And nice aroma. So everything should be plenty here. Let there be rich growth of flora. And let there be fauna be rich. Let there be good cattle. Plenty of cattle. Plenty of wild animals. So you look at an elephant, you get a joy. Everyone looks at the elephant, especially Kerala. People are mad about elephants. They go and do. Chanda, they will also. They do keep like this. So the elephant, they enjoy. Elephant looks so beautiful. So let there be plenty of everything. Everything should be plenty here. So the pravritti lakshana is to have prosperity. Prosperity means all our needs are met with. And everything is plenty here. That is required actually. You can't have starving. Veda does not speak about starvation. Everything should be. It's not my statement. It is what I say from the quote of Shankaracharya. That's why I have written and brought it here. The introduction to the Gita, he says, and later elsewhere also it is told. So, two types of dharmas are there, pravritti lakshana and nivritti lakshana. Nivritti lakshana dharma. Nivritti lakshana is highest good. And the word dharma also you should understand. Dharma is not doing some charity. Dharma means something which is inherent in a thing, something which is innate in a thing, without which it cannot exist. That is the dharma. Dharma means not doing charity, that means that's not the real meaning. The real meaning of dharma is very a natural state without which it cannot exist. For example, fire has to be, should give you heat. Fire should be hot. When you touch it, it will burn you. Water will be cool. Water is cool. That is its dharma. Fire is hot. That is its dharma. The water flows down. It is dharma. From higher regions to lower regions, it will flow. That is the dharma of the water. Fire will go up. That is the dharma. The earth has got a smell. When it rains, then you get the smell of the earth. So it is its dharma, it is its quality. So that is dharma. If it is not there, if water starts flowing upwards, the fire is very cold, you cannot cook food. So if that dharma is not there, it is no more, that product is no more there, that object is not there. So that is actually the word meaning of dharma. Dharma means because of that innate quality, inherent quality, inherent nature, it exists. Otherwise, it will not exist. It will not, it cannot exist. It cannot have that name. So he speaks about pravritti lakshana dharma and nivritti lakshana dharma. What is pravritti? Action. So he speaks about to act, how one has to behave. So we are all living beings, whichever is born here, we are involved in some activity. Everything is active here. The trees are growing. You are growing, trees are also growing. You are eating, the trees are also eating. The dog eats, the trees eat, the ant eats, we eat. So, and in order to eat, we work, we do something. You want to be happy, the dog also wants to be happy. You want a good bed, the dog also wants good bed. The dog makes a small pit and then sleeps there. So in order to be comfortable, in order to be happy, so all these things here, they are involved in an activity, in some activity, so that they will be happy. Every one of us, everything here, whatever is born here, they are functioning. They are involved in some form of activity so that they will be happy. So that pravritti is there. All pravritti, all action, all your actions are for the sake of enriching yourself, for the sake of acquiring comforts, to be happy here. All our activities to make our life prosperous. Up in there motivates us to work for it. Abhyudaya can only bring everything. Plenty means you become happy. I want this. How much you want? You give everything to me. Everything I want here. So you want how much? How much land? Oh. Whatever possible you give. So we all want to be happy. We want to be rich. We want to have everything. So for that we are working actually. So all our activities, all our movements, all our thoughts, not physical activity, even the mental thoughts, intellectual thinking, all these activities, all the pravrittis are for Abhyudaya, to make us rich, rich in all respects, rich in thinking, rich in comforts, rich in our interaction with everybody. My children should love me much. I should have good relationship with all people here. Everyone should love me. I hate you if someone says you don't like it. I love you. Oh, very good. Swamiji, you are a wonderful person. Yes. So we all feel that way. You know? So you want everything rich. Don't confine richness means money. Everything you want to reach. Everybody should accept me. You want everybody to accept you. Oh, you have done a good work. You are very happy. That is us. You sang very well. Yes, Swamiji. Thank you, Swamiji. No. Hari Om, Swamiji. So we have that pravritti there. For that, they have prescribed a dharma. So, because activity, action is inevitable, you cannot remain without activity. Activity is a part of our life. Without activity, we cannot exist. So, if somebody wants to, I don't want to do any activity, I'll remain quiet. It is not possible. You cannot remain quiet. You will be doing something or other. So, without action, renunciation of action and all these things are imaginary words. It is not possible. You will be active. So, we are all involved in some form of activity. Always we are active. Something or other we are doing all day. And that should be governed by a certain law. that should have a dharma. That should be said. The pravritti should have its dharma. If you violate this dharma, then it will create problem for you. If, as I told you, that way the water will flow down. The water started going up. The sea water swells up. The Kerala will be submerged. So water should maintain its dharma. Likewise, all the activities, pravrittis, should be according to a certain dharma, that is called pravritti dharma. And beyond that, transcending that, there is another one which is called nivritti. So nivritti is something which is superior to, which brings the highest good actually. This is good, it's very good actually. But that is something, the most high, the most good. That is how it is used in the West. So two types of dharmas are spoken in this. So what is this dharma? That I will come to this now. So what for we are, why we are active? Why you are engaged in action? Why you do something? To do something, to get involved in an action, there should be some push actually. You won't do any activity unless there is some result. So you go there and come. I say, you go there and come. It's only Papa can go there and come, go there and come. Papa can only do that. Otherwise, you go there. Why should I go? What for? You are sending me there to go. What for? Nothing. Nothing means, why should I go? You see. So you won't go. Only Papa will go. You go. Ram says, I will go. Ram says, I can. You come. Come. All of them, suppose if I say, you go, you won't go. Why should I go? So all the actions we do, perform, has got a purpose. What is that purpose? The purpose means we want to enrich ourselves. All our activities are to enrich ourselves, to make our life more prosperous, to make it more plenty. So all activities are to acquire something. So acquisition. I want more food. Then grow more food. Annam bahu kurvita. That's a Vedic mantra. Produce more anna. Anna does not mean the rice, cooked rice. Anna means everything is rice. Whatever that is being taken as food here. What we eat, somebody else eats something else. The cow eats something, the dog eats something, all these things should be richer. Annam bahu kurvita, sadvratam, tasmat yaya kaya cha vidaya bahuannam prapnuyat. The Veda mantra, Upanishad mantra. So let there be growth, let there be rich growth of food. You make it. So whenever we are involved in an activity, all actions succeed a desire for. All actions are to acquire something, to achieve something. And there is a desire to achieve it. Lot of pain is there. Do you want? No, I don't want. Lot of pressure is there. Yes, please give me. So, all our activities, all activities are succeed a desire. So that desire is called in Sanskrit as kama. So the desire is for some material, some comfort. It can be house, it can be son, it can be a daughter, it can be a wife, it can be money, it can be land, it can be, I want a good cow, I want a good elephant, I want good trees. I want good yield in my crops. And there should not be any mosquito here. All things are, all are diseases only. So all diseases are centered on objects. Objects which will make us, which will give us comfort. So our diseases are to acquire objects which can make us happy. So that is also, there are the positive side and the negative side. We want certain objects which will make us happy. We don't want certain objects which will make us unhappy. So we want to get rid of those objects. So we want to acquire certain objects and we want to get rid of some other objects. Both are there. So we, something we like, we want to have it. Something we don't like, we want to get rid of it. For that purpose, activities happen. So this, they say, dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Artha, kama is there. Two things are there. Artha means all objects which will make us happy. Either the acquisition will make us happy or renunciation of that will make us happy. Throwing away, getting rid of that will make us happy. And that desire is there. That desire only prompts us, makes us to do the activity. The desire only makes us to do the activity. So now they say, this should not disturb your acquisition, your enriching yourself. When you earn your prosperity, when you go for your prosperous life, when you are involved in your activity to acquire something and to make you richer, do not disturb other things here. Do not disturb the happiness of other things here. You can earn as much as you want, everything you can earn, without disturbing the other thing. I want money, I should not steal your money. I should not rob you of your money to make me rich. I want food. Your food is kept there, I take away and eat, and then you don't have food. That's not correct. That will disturb you. When you are disturbed, you will disturb me. Because here everything is connected to everything here. We have a wrong notion that we are independent. Nothing is independent here. It is one organic whole. You are intimately connected to me. Everything here is intimately connected to me. Everything is intimately connected to you. Everything is intimately connected to everything other. Every other thing. So all are interconnected here. So my earning, my comforts, my happiness should not disturb the happiness of the other person. If it disturbs, that will disturb you. Because you are disturbing yourself. You are intimately connected to. You have a knife. You want to see whether it is sharp. You want to cut it. You can't cut your finger. You don't test it here. So likewise, if you earn your happiness, disturbing the happiness of other thing, it is like cutting your own finger to test whether the knife is sharp or not. So that is what is called pravritti dharma. Artha kama, the kama, your kama. Kama does not mean, the Malayalam meaning is not correct. Kama means desire. Kama is Malayalam also same thing. Kama means desire. Your desires are perfectly okay. You can desire for anything and achieve it also. But to see that it does not disturb the other person. So that is the dharma. Pravarti dharma. So he speaks about pravarti dharma. You are earning your objects to make you happy, to enrich yourself, to become prosperous in life. Do not disturb the other person. Do not disturb anything here. You should not even disturb water. You should not even disturb fire. There is a Veda mantra which says that you should not spit in water. In our ashram, in Sivananda ashram, there was one Swamiji whose name was Muktananda, not our Swamiji Muktananda, Canadian, a tall fellow, very big size. So he hails from Canada. It's a very cold country. So when hot season, summer season, he used to stay in the ashram. So he will go to Ganga, which is very cool, water is very cool. He will swim there for 2-3 hours. And we cannot stay there for more than 1 minute. It is very cold, you will come out, ice melting. But he will be there for hours together. And he used to go and study his own Swamiji, called Swami Brahmanandaji. So one day he went there and told, somebody told him, Swamiji, Muktananda is swimming in the river. Then Swamiji told, you should not swim in the river. Ganga, you should not swim, he said. He cannot understand what it is. He cannot understand, but he simply obeyed Swamiji's command. You should not disturb, you should not swim in river. That is prohibited. You are disturbing. Some of our mommies may be knowing. When the girls walk, tap, 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 like that, hey, don't disturb the earth, they used to say. Bhumiya kulukkade. Those days they used to say, you can't jump on this, you cannot go like this. Don't disturb this mother earth. Nowadays, too many girls might not have, should, cannot be told like that. They will not like it. And the mommies will not tell that also. Also, nothing should be disturbed here. Everything. So you should feel that everything is connected to you. Even if you don't feel that you are denying a truth, the effect will be there. You believe that the fire will be not burn you and put your finger there. Whatever you believe, whatever you think, whatever your rationality, the fire will burn your finger. So this is pravarti lakshana. While you earn whatever you want, while you achieve your happiness, you acquire your happiness, do not disturb anything here. And you follow that dharma. That dharma is called karma yoga. Two things are told here. That is, one is yoga and sannyas. Yoga and tyaga. Yoga is dvidanishta pura proktamayana jnana yogena sankhyanam karma yogena yoginam. This is yoga. Yoga means not the hatha yoga. Yoga according to the Bhagavad Gita and according to the shastras also, yoga means karma yoga. Discharging one's functions, duties. All actions should be performed without disturbing the other thing. Because you are intimately connected to everything here, you should not disturb anything. So that is what is called yoga, karma yoga. And what is sankhya? Kamyanam karmanam nyasam sanyasam kavayo viduhu. So the activities are prompted by desires. Because some desire is there in the mind. Some desire is there in the mind. Up to what time? 11:15. some desire is there in the mind, we have to necessarily act. Activities, without activity it is not possible. So activities will be there. There are desires, there are karma is there, the karma will be there. Karma is the mother, karma is the child. Avidya kama karma. Karma is there. Some, I want this. Then you have to do the activity. So you root this. All the pravarti should be according to pravarti lakshana dharma. What dharma you have to follow. That is what is called karma yoga. And what is sankhya? If the mind is free of desires, then you will be active. In that case, what you do, all the you acquire, you achieve everything. And that is that you don't feel, you don't have a possession over that. You don't have a feeling it is mine. The mindness will not be there. So ashram is there. Ashram is rich means who is rich? Ashram rich means not, Muktan Swamiji is not rich. Ashram is rich means ashram is rich. So he has no abhimana over that. He has no feeling of, it is mine, that feeling is not there. That I-ness is not there. Ego is not there. Without specific desire, any specific desire, whatever activity we do, that is, Bappa says, all the actions are consecrated to Rama. Whatever God prompts, that activity naturally takes place. It takes place in some, the activity takes place. So that activity, it is not because of some desire from within, it is a prompting from God. So accordingly they act. So that act is not act, it is tyaga, because kama tyaga is already there. So tyaga means sannyasa. Sannyasa means tyaga. What is the tyaga? The mind will not entertain any desire. Whatever it is provided is fine. It is Ram's will. Papa says that it is Ram's will. The will of Ram. So I don't have any will or wish or desire. Whatever he makes me do through this instrument, it is fine for me. Whether it is good or bad, that thought is not there. That is what is called Nivritti Lakshana. So one, Pravritti Lakshana. The other is Nivritti Lakshana. Pravritti Lakshana will bring up to there. It will, you will be comfortable here. Everything will be plenty here. It will bring you prosperity. And Nivritti Lakshana will take you beyond prosperity. Nivritti Lakshana does not mean poverty. It is takes poverty or prosperity, it makes no difference. Poverty and prosperity are does not matter to us. So because you have transcended that condition, you are in a state of bliss all the time. Why this is said? Because initially the Shastra says you are divine. You are basically divine. Everyone, everything here is Bhagavat Swarupa only. His Vishwarupa. His Virat Swarupa only. What we see here is his Virat Swarupa. So whatever I see here, it is his form. All the names and all the forms are Ram only. Papa says Ram only. All the names are all the forms are Bhagavan Swarupa only. One who can behold that. For him, neither the comfort is also Ram, the stress is also Ram, the pain is also Ram. Sukha dukkhe samegrutva labha labho jaya jayau. All these things are the sukha and dukkha are equal to me. Labha and Alabha, Nashta, all are equal. So that is Nivrtilakshana. So these two are there. And already we are all liberated souls only. There is some error in our this what is called computer, this computer here. So that the artificial intelligence, you know, there is some error in the connection has not been properly made, so some error is there. That is why we are seeking liberation, already liberated. So that is we are not achieving liberation, we are not going to get liberation. Liberation is already there. Somehow there is a wrong notion that we are bound. Your base, your nature is Ananda, your Ananda Swarupa. Ananda, your Swarupa is Ananda. Where is Dukkha? It is a dream actually. It is an imagination. So, just to bring you back to your real, that it says some forgetfulness is there. You have forgotten your real nature. And to make you understand your real nature, the Shastra speaks about that. So the liberation is for the liberated one only and not for those who are bound actually. So your Swarupa is Ananda. This is Ananda Ashram. Your Swarupa is Ananda. And he had a song, Anandoham, Anandoham, Anandam Brahma Anandam. Your Swarupa is Ananda. So that is promised in Bhagavad Gita, Hari Om Tat Sat.